One that you and Shane each own 50% of this company.
What do you mean, a lie?
I don't know.
You very well know that there are four of us and that we own four equal shares.
Uh-oh! Really?
You also know that you didn't build this company by yourself. While you were out front doing your thing, I and a lot of others were behind the scenes helping to grow and make this company successful. We've all worked equally as hard as you have. And this morning, I called an emergency meeting of the board of directors.
What?
I wasn't notified.
You weren't notified? That's really unfortunate. But let me assure you, there are going to be some changes around the office. Changes starting with the dress code.
Changes?
Dress code?
Yeah, the dress code. It's going to be a little less formal, more casual at the office. In fact, cut-off jeans might be the dress of the day at the office.
Cut-off jeans?
Number two, how about a little profanity in the office? Well, every now and then, a little sprinkling of profanity, if the situation warrants, at the office would be just fine.
What the?
And third, drinking on the job. Yep.
What?
Yes. At the end of a long, hard day at the office, how about an ice-cold alcoholic beverage to quench your thirst?
You gotta be kidding me!
But Vince, what all this means is that earlier today, I stepped down as the CEO of this company.
You what?
But not before I handpicked my own successor.
Oh, no.
And that new CEO, will have full power and privileges to run this company as he sees fit. So, Vince, Shane, allow Stephanie and me to introduce you to the new CEO.
Oh no, this can't be.
Well, I think you heard what happened at the meeting today, so let's go ahead and start with that dress code thing. I can go ahead and take off this power tie because I no longer need this power tie because, Vince, you always know that old Stone Cold always has the power finger, so here's to you.
He's the CEO!
And I apologize for all this paperwork and the clipboards. That's not usually my style, but hell, when you take a sumbitch like me and you put him in a corporate setting, it takes a while to get the adjustments down just right. But as you always say, Vince, nonetheless, in any event, these corporate problems and solutions notwithstanding, you can bet your ass that Stone Cold Steve Austin is gonna do everything in his power to make this transition as soon as possible.
I think I'm going to lock this. Rattlesnakes don't make good CEOs!
Hell, I'm starting to get used to this corporate crap already. Now let's get down to business. What we decided at this meeting today, Vince, is at a later time, place, and conditions to be determined by me, the CEO, I will have a title match, and I will take back my WWF title.
He's calling the shots.
Number two, and look at me when I speak to you, you little bastard. You ain't got but 25% chump change. You look at me, delegate this authority, I'll come down there and beat your damn brains in. For the immediate future, Vince, my focus is on you and your little boy Wonder there right beside you. At our next pay-per-view event, which is King of the Ring, and nobody knows more than Stone Cold Steve Austin how important that damn event is. Stone Cold Steve Austin is going to be in a handicap match. And it will be me in one corner, and Vince, it'll be you and that little bastard son of yours in the other corner.
Wow! Stone Cold versus both the big mans at the
King
of the
Ring. And finally, for the record, I get to beat both your asses at one time, and that's all I got to say about that.
Shane McMahon is not a... He's not a... You know, he's not...
Well, let me tell you something. You're on, pal. The two of us, two McMahons, can take an Austin any day of the week.
Right.
Now, I may have to have a few stipulations here and there, but Pally, you're on. He's on.
Nonetheless, those stipulations notwithstanding, I really don't give a rat's ass what you think, Vince. Now, moving on to our next little deal. Shane, you come out here throwing your weight around, but like I said, you got your little chump change, 25%. I'm gonna let a son of a bitch really show you how to delegate authority since I got my 50% right here in my back pocket. Little game you played last week with X-Pac and Kane, screwing them out of the titles. You think you still got a big shot, your little suit over there. I think you look like a piece of crap.
Believe
this.
You wanna
play games? Here's what I got for you. Tonight, Shane, you will be in a handicap match, and it will be you, your little yellow ass, in one corner, and in that other corner, you will have X-Pac and Kane.
Oh, Lord! The Boy Wonder's going down tonight! Tonight!
Hey, but I'm a good sport, so I will say good luck, you little bastard. All right. As far as the rest of the card goes for the evening's festivities, hell, Vince, I know that you screwed me around, but in the process, you walked on a couple other people. So what I'm going to do with the rest of the members of the union, the three remaining members, as my notes tell me here, that would be Shamrock, Test, and Show. They get a free pass tonight. Tonight, on Raw, they can have a match with anybody in this damn building that they see fit with, and that's what I got to say to them.
Anybody?
Big opportunity for the union tonight.
As far as Mick Foley goes, and he's not here with us tonight, and on a personal note, I'd like to say, get well, Mick Foley, you crazy bastard.
Jeez.
Triple H, you're in your little sidekick China there. You like to cripple people, hit somebody in the knee with a sledgehammer, that's all fine and well. Because as vicious as that was, I kind of liked it the most. Tonight, you're going to see what it feels like to be on the other end of the stick here, son. Because what you're going to do, and I think this is probably a first, is have a cast match. Now, what does that mean, Stone Cold? It means this. Since The Rock's arm is in a cast, I figure what you do, and you got two good legs there, is we're going to put your damn leg in a full cast all the way up to your little hip, and you get to wrestle The Rock in a leg cast tonight on Raw.
That's a first. I've never heard of that.
How can he do that?
And I don't care how you go about it, if you just go limping around like this and let The Rock beat the hell out of you, maybe that's what's going to happen. That's pretty much the festivities for this night. Now, if anybody in that ring has a problem with the rules that old Stone Cold is laying down right now, you can find my dressing room back there, get your ass in line, knock on a door, and if I ain't busy drinking too much beer, I'll open the sandwich up and talk to you. And that's the bottom line. Because Stone Cold said so.